she knows she's got everything that a woman needs to get a man. Yeah, yeah. How can she lose what suit she used? 36, 24, 36. What a winning hand, 'cause she's a big house. She's mighty, mighty, just letting it all hang out. She's a brick.
WPEB 88.1 FM, your community radio station in West Philly.
For this example, we took a look at a new car and a used car of the same make and model. and tried to estimate the various expenses we might.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. You're tuned in to Hope for Philadelphia on WPEB 88.1 FM. That was a tribute to our 4th of July. That was actually Nelson Diamond. Nelson Diamond performing America. Happy birthday, and happy birthday to you. It is America. Everybody who tuned in to WPEB 88.1 FM, as well as on our Ustream page, thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen, for tuning in. May God bless you once again. If it's your birthday, happy birthday to you, and again, happy birthday to America. So we are blessed today and highly favored. We're having slight technical difficulties with the computer, but hopefully later that will work out. You know what? That will work out fine. Ladies and gentlemen, all day today, we will be praying. We're going to dedicate this broadcast today strictly to prayer. If you would like to pray for your city, your state, your country, your neighborhood, your community, your family, if you would like to pray, even if you know someone who's in a hospital, if you know someone who's having a hard time, and you would like to pray for yourself or for someone, this is the day to do it. Amen. Amen. If you need prayer, if you are in need of prayer and you would like for us to pray specifically for you, this is the day for you as well. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the day we're strictly doing prayer. And we never dedicated a whole broadcast strictly to prayer. And I believe that this is the one. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. So once again, I'm going to give you the few options to pray or to call in and contact us with prayer or prayer request. Of course, on the radio, which is 215-472-0882. Again, it's 215-472-0882. One more time, to call into the radio is 215-472-0882. If you do not feel comfortable speaking on the radio, but you would still like prayer, or you would like for us to pray for someone, you can go ahead and call our office at 215-472-0881. 215-472-0881. So the prayer is on the radio is 215-472-0882. Off the radio is 215-472-0881. If you're too shy and you don't feel comfortable enough or secure enough to contact us and voice, you can also email us and send us an anonymous email at hopeforphiladelphia@gmail.com. You can also message us on our Facebook page, facebook.com/hopeforphiladelphia. And if you search in Hope for Philadelphia prayer page, we have a strict page. It's a page specifically for praying, prayer requests, for putting your prayers on there, and we'll read them if you want us to do that. If you put something on our prayer page and you want us to read it, we will read it for you. So I feel a move of God in here today. I don't know about anybody else, but I know I feel a move of God up in here today. I just can feel the spirit. I can feel the callers getting ready to call in. So let me hurry up and pray so I can open the floor to all of our callers who's going to be praying in. And oh my God, I just feel that this broadcast is just going to be so different. We have Jeremy Griffin here with us. Good morning, Jerm.
Hey, how you doing, Cash?
I'm doing pretty good. This specific broadcast is going to be so different. Let us pray, and then let me open the floor strictly to prayer. If you know you're a pastor, if you know that you are a evangelist, if you are a member of the church, even if you're just a friend in the community and you would like to pray, whomever you are, if you serve the God that I serve, go ahead and I just feel that this broadcast is going to touch, is going to save, it's going to transform the world, it's going to transform the city, the state, and the world, and the nations for Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. So let me pray and then open the floor. Amen. Amen. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I just pray right now, Father God, and I just ask you to have your way, Father God. Have your way right now, Lord. Have your way for all that you're doing for us this morning on this broadcast, Father God. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I just pray right now over Philadelphia, all of our callers who's going to call in, everybody who needs prayer, Father God, allow them, encourage them to say, I need to make that call. I need to make that call. I need prayer. I'm in a difficult situation or I'm in a confused situation and I don't know exactly what to do. So I definitely want to reach out to Hope You and pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, if anyone is saying that, encourage them to go ahead and give us a call or contact us online. Father God, allow the music that we play also, that we play on the broadcast today, also a touch and transform our listeners and our supporters. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we're doing this all for you, Lord. We give you all the glory, the honor, and the praise in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Amen. First of all, I would like to say happy belated the 4th of July. 4th of July was right. Incredible. It was very incredible. I loved it. I was at a big shout out to the Longcrest Stational Center and Park. Their fireworks were so amazing. We have people on our Facebook page that are sending us their fireworks pictures. So if you took any pictures last night of the fireworks, go ahead and post them up on our Facebook page, our original Facebook page, which is facebook.com/hopeforphiladelphia. And just go ahead and post it. My pictures was amazing. I'm going to try to see if I can upload and play a video for you today. The Lord just been blessing me. I'm trying to be patient, but I just want to dive right into what the Lord has done for me. My God, let me stay focused on 4th of July for just two more minutes. So the recreational center did an amazing fireworks. My family has a tradition of going to the Longcrest Recreational Center, which is in the northeast section of Philadelphia, off of Rising Sun and Comley. Rising Sun and Comley is where that location is. And every year, actually yesterday, they celebrated their 100th anniversary of doing the fireworks, of having a fireworks display. And it's more than just fireworks display at this field. They do bingo for senior citizens. They had a flea market. Yeah, and what I saw when I seen the dedication, it was like a stone, kind of like a cemetery stone, right. But it was a dedication to those in the military.
Okay.
And for it to be 4th of July, and for me to step foot at this park, and that's the very first thing I saw, I was like, wow, this is just incredible.
Yeah.
So I saw that with me and my mom and a couple others, and from that, then I saw the first flea market. The first vendor was an incredible guy. He was selling frames that had bats in the frame. Like, have you ever been to a house and seen
you gotta explain that one, Cash.
Have you ever been to a house and seen a frame on a wall that had like butterflies in it?
Yeah.
Like a collection, like a butterfly.
So. Yeah.
I've seen it in plenty of houses, maybe like in bathrooms or in living rooms, where right. people collect butterflies that are in like a picture frame, which is normal. But I've never seen bats.
Me neither.
Bats.
Never.
Like B-A-T-S, like the animal, bats, in a picture frame that he was selling.
Interesting. Wow.
Now,
how much are they going for?
He actually wanted $22 a frame.
Okay.
Yeah, so very quickly, I know we got to get moving on. Very quickly, I have seen bats in real life.
Right.
I have seen bats in real life in person. And very quickly to go to a bat story, I was on my way to the orthodontics, the dentist, and Temple University, give a shout out to you, Kornberg School of Dentistry, and right there at Broad and Allegheny in North Philadelphia, I was on my way inside the building. When next thing was like taking pictures, I thought it was like the ground. Well, it was facing towards the ground. And it was unexpected. I'm, you know, bats right. are flying. Why gonna shock me when I seen a bat flapping around in broad daylight on the ground? And so I went to the dentist, you know, spent an hour in there and getting my, you know, a dentist checkup. And it was quite disturbing, but it got the bat off the street. I mean, I guess it wasn't disturbing because it wasn't aggressive with it. But basically what he did was he picked it up and he just tossed it into a flower bed.
A flower bed.
So he just picked it up and tossed it. And I'm like, it really? Is that what the animal rescue
is that
do?
Is that the
protocol to pick
the
up bats
protocol?
And just throw it in a flower bed? But what the animal rescue employee said was most likely, because bats are nocturnal.
Right.
So what he said was that he must have been on a branch in a tree, and that branch fell or broke, which made the bat to fall and land on the ground, which woke him up. Or if he was trying to go back to sleep, but he was like flapping around. And
interesting.
So I have seen bats before. But anyway, back to 4th of July. If you have any 4th of July pictures or anything like that, fireworks, a cookout, whatever you did for us, your images on our page, and we will be glad to see them. So we're going to now open the floor to anybody who wants 572 to be on the radio, 215-472-0881 to be off the radio, and facebook.com/hopeforphiladelphia to send us a message. Hope for, and of course, our Facebook search, Hope for Philadelphia prayer page. That's Hope for Philadelphia prayer page. So we're gonna continue praying. I'm gonna ask Jeremy.
Okay. Yeah, I would just like to thank you, Heavenly Father, for the wonderful day that you have given us, this beautiful Sunday morning that me and Cashion was able to wake up and even get to the studio, able to pray with the wonderful viewers over here at WPEB. Please bless this ministry. Please bless this city. I know there's a hope for Philadelphia out here because I'm hoping for it, Cashion hoping for it, and everyone I know hoping for it. We got to make a change, Jesus. Please help us all to do what we need to do tomorrow at our jobs, at our schools, at our summer camps, and whatever else is going on. Please help you just to lead the way, God. And our cities and our homes and our families, help you to make all our paths straight, Jesus. Please help us to just do your will, God, and to remember that you're the one. You're the one who created us. You're the one who knows where we're going. You're the one who knows exactly what we need to do to succeed, to prosper. Yes, God. And please help us just to figure out where we need to go and the next step in our lives and which we need to take to be a part of your plan and your will for us, Jesus Christ. I please thank you, God, for the wonderful family I was blessed with and the wonderful friends I was blessed with, Jesus. I think about yesterday, 4th of July, all the troops that have died for our country, all the founding fathers who have died, all the other people in our nation who has fallen, died in the grave and have nowhere to go but sadly hell. But I know that there was some that knew you, Jesus Christ, and they will see you, and I will see them too. God, please bless all the people, all the families of the veterans who are thinking about their families yesterday. Think about their families who have died on Memorial Day, Labor Day. Please, God, help them to know that they will see them again if they put their trust in Jesus Christ. God, I hope and pray that this summer is a very productive summer for those who have lived years and years and have not been productive. I want to pray to God that you were able to see them through the pain and through the unproductivity. God, I just want to lastly say that you are a good God and that you will see us through all our problems. And in Jesus' name, amen. Okay, Cashion, we'll be right back. All right, Cash.
So, ladies and gentlemen, we have people calling in all morning long, and I just want to thank God for everything that He has done for us. So, you know, God is just so good. Thank you so much, Jeremy, for praying for us. And, you know, that is a very good prayer. I'm trying to get this computer. The computer's acting a little weird this morning, so I'm trying to get our music and our weather report that we usually do and everything up here, and it's not quite running just right. so I'm going to be working on that in just a moment. But right now, we have a person on the line. Hello and good morning. Hello, can you hear me? Hello, good morning.
Good morning, how are you?
I'm doing great, how are you?
Good.
Good, good, good. What's your name and tell us where you're calling from?
Okay, I'm calling from Philadelphia Grace Tabernacle Christian Church, where our pastor is Pastor Leon Montgomery.
Amen. Go ahead.
I would like to pray, and I have a prayer request for just for the body of Christ to have a closer walk with the Lord. And being confident that God does hear us, and because of that, we can come to Him with all our cares.
Amen. Yes, absolutely. That is, first of all, I would like to congratulate you and thank you for calling in to us this morning. I also would like to give a shout out to Grace Tabernacle Christian Church. Hallelujah. Yes, we give you guys a shout out all the time. So if you will, I also heard that you have a prayer request, and go ahead and begin praying over the airways, and just allow the Lord to lead you and bless you.
All right. Thank you. Hallelujah. Praise you, God. We thank you first this morning for just allowing us the opportunity to come to you, casting our cares upon you, Lord God. First, we ask forgiveness of all sins, our thoughts, our action, our deeds, Lord. Things that hinder us, Lord God, from being who you called us to be, Lord God. We just believe your word, Lord God, so we thank you for that. I ask first for prayer, Lord God, for just a closer walk with you, Lord God, that we, your people, Lord God, know you for the power of your resurrection, Lord God. You are our living Savior, Lord God, and we thank you for that. I pray for souls today, Lord God. I pray for souls that don't know you from the pardon of their sins, Lord God. I ask that you touch, Lord God. I ask you touch God's people, Lord God, that we be sensitive to your spirit, Lord God, that we can share you with everyone we come in contact with, Lord God. Through your word, Lord God, through our presence, Lord God, showing your love, Lord God. Help us to love others. That's how they know that you exist, Lord God. And I ask for prayer, Lord God, for our young people, Lord God. Touch them, Lord God. Keep a hedge of protection around them, Lord God. Lead them not temptation. Deliver them from the enemy, Lord God. I pray for the elderly, Lord God. I pray for that you comfort our elderly, Lord God. I thank you, Lord God, for the caregivers, Lord God, for someone that is in a sickly or elderly, Lord God. I ask you to touch them. Give them patience, Lord God. I thank you in advance, Lord God. Pray, Lord God, for our leaders, Lord God. First, our pastors and ministers of the gospel, Lord God, as they lead your word, Lord God. Lead them not to temptation. Deliver them from the enemy, Lord God. Encourage them in you, Lord God, because it can get rough when when your people is serving you, Lord God. But you are with us, Lord God, and we can be confident of that, Lord God, because you said you would never leave us nor forsake us. So we thank you for your word, Lord God. I pray for our president, Lord God. I pray for this country as a whole, Lord God, that we be able to have the faith, Lord God, to stand on your word and your promises, Lord God. We thank you that you are totally in control of everything, and all things work together for the good to those who love you and are called according to your purpose, Lord God. So I ask you that you help us to love you, Lord God. You said we love you, we'll keep your commandments, Lord God. So help us to love you so we can keep your word, Lord God. I pray for this ministry, this radio ministry, Lord God. I thank you for the leaders of this ministry, Lord God, the radio announcers, the production people, everyone involved, Lord God, that has a desire, Lord God, to share you with the anyone who has an ear, Lord God. So touch them right now. Encourage them, Lord God. Continue to give them the faith, Lord God, to go to the byways and highways, Lord God, sharing the gospel that you are alive and you want people saved, Lord God. So I thank you for that. I pray for people in the hospital now that you touch them, Lord God. Jehovah Rapha, be their healer, Lord God. Touch them, Lord God. And I thank you, Lord God. You're just so wonderful and awesome, Lord God, that we can cast all our cares upon you, Lord God, because you do care for us, Lord God. Help us, Lord God, to continue to be the people that you called us to be, and I'll be ever more careful to just praise you and thank you in Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you so much, Lord, for praying into us, and thank you for tuning in. Grace Tabernacle Christian Church. Tell us, what's your location and what time is your service today?
Okay, we're located on 1517 South 52nd Street, which would be, you come in on the door of 52nd and Greenway in Southwest Philadelphia, off of 52nd and Woodland. Our service starts today at 11 a.m., and we're just looking forward to have a great time in the Lord.
Okay, now you also had a prayer request. I want to ask you to repeat your prayer request one more time for us.
Just basically, our prayer request is for God's people to have a closer walk with the Lord. To mine personally is just, you know, continue to trust the Lord and help and not get caught up in what I see, but just to live by faith and pray for my church, my church family, mainly the youth. Youth department. That's basically it.
Amen. Thank you so much, Pam, for calling in. May God bless you.
All right. Thank you. God bless you guys.
All right. Bye bye. That was Miss Pam from Grace Tabernacle Christian Church. Go ahead and continue calling. That's what I'm talking about. Great prayer right there. Great prayer. Amen. Hallelujah. So right now we're playing Tasha Cobbs, For Your Glory, right here on WPEB. And when we come back, I'm going to talk about the least and most patriotic states. Did yours come in top 10? You'll find out on WPEB 88.1 FM.
Find favor in your sight, Lord, please hear my heart's cry. I'm desperately waiting to be where you are. Across the hottest desert, I'll travel.
be where you are. I wanna be where you are. Gotta be where you are. Come on, raise it before I'm sick. Wanna be where you are. Gotta be.
Gotta be where.
That was For Your Glory on by Tasha Combs. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. You're tuned into Philadelphia's WPEB 88.1 FM. Go ahead and continue giving us a call. Call 215-472-0882. That's 215-472-0882 to be on the radio. Off the radio is 215-472-0881, 215-472-0881. Speaking of Independence Day, according to Channel 6 Action News, 6abc.com, how patriotic is your state? Just in time for Independence Day comes a new list ranking each state on their level of patriotism for 2015. Number 10 was Georgia. Georgia. Number 9 was South Carolina. Number 8, New Hampshire. Number 7, North Carolina. Number 6, Maine. What's the top 5? I'll tell you right after this song. It's not called Fireworks, but it's called Fire by Michelle Williams right here on WPEB 88.1. FM.
They say anything that is worth it, you must take it slow. They know when you come around, ain't no choice but to grow. Oh, oh. And listen for what you say. And I lay down my head. I don't know. Smelling like smoke. Oh, no. Yep, that's just what you said. It went straight to
That is fire by Michelle Williams. You know, everybody has to know by now on my stage who Michelle Williams is. She's the singer of When Jesus Say Yes, Nobody Can Say No. So she also has Fire and many other songs. Let's get a check out. Let's see if our computer will allow, and let's get a check out on your weather for today. Let's go to 6ABC, Chris Sowers.
And show you what's going on, especially down on the Jersey Shore. We're down there now in Atlantic City. Atlantic City was beautiful yesterday. We had a little bit of cloud cover, but the sun broke through, and it actually turned out to be a pretty nice beach day. This morning will be very similar. You're going to start out with some clouds, and then by afternoon, things will brighten up again. Double scan live, crystal clear. We don't have any moisture out there, which is a good thing. It looks like the second half of this holiday weekend promises to be a whole lot better than what we saw yesterday. Rainfall totals really only ranged from 0.05 of an inch to about 0.1 of an inch, and a lot of that was mainly west of the city. So not too bad yesterday. Temperature 68 degrees, dew point 60. Winds officially are calm at the airport, and our barometer holding steady at 30.09 inches. Quakertown 61, Martins Creek 61, Warrington 66, Pottstown 64, and Coatesville checking in at 62. South Jersey, Buna 65, Gandy's Beach 65. Glassboro 61, and on the boards in Atlantic City and Avalon, they both share 69. Here's Satellite 6 along with Action Radar, and high pressure is kind of skirting on by to the north. It'll situate itself right there over Binghamton and pass on by to the east, pushing across New England, and that should suppress most of this cloud cover to the south later this afternoon. So whatever clouds you are seeing this morning, along with the patchy fog, a lot of that should get out of here right around 9, 10 o'clock this morning. And from that point on, it's just a combination of sun and clouds, as you can clearly see here on Future Tracker 6. So again, it should be a really nice day. Tomorrow, things are going to change a little bit. We noticed some cloud cover rolling on in. These are those high, thin clouds. The sun will still shine right through that, but they're coming from the south. The humidity will also increase along with this, and that leads to the possibility of a few spotty thunderstorms late in the day. They will be more widespread in coverage and intensity as we get into Tuesday and Wednesday. So spotty for tomorrow, spotty again for Tuesday, but just a little bit more activity Tuesday, and then Wednesday it becomes more widespread. For the Poconos today, partly sunny, 77 degrees is the forecasted high, and for the Jersey Shore, we've eliminated that risk for rip currents today. 73, that's your ocean water temperature. Expect morning clouds and then afternoon sunshine, a nice day, 78 degrees right there on the sand. Boating forecast, again, it should be a little easier, maybe a little rough for some of the smaller boats. Seas of 3 to 4 feet, so a little choppy. Winds out of the southeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour, high tide occurring at 7:40 this morning. Again, expect a combination of sun and clouds. Western suburbs, Reading, 86 degrees. You're dealing with some patchy fog out there this morning. That should lift fairly quickly. Allentown, 85. Lancaster, 84. Sun and clouds and warmer. Philadelphia will check in at 87 later this afternoon. The exclusive AccuWeather 7-day forecast. Again, Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. Spotty thunderstorms are possible each and every day. 87 tomorrow, 88 Tuesday. Wednesday, we top out at 89. And this is when the cold front pulls through. Numerous showers and thunderstorms expected. Thursday, sun and clouds, 86. Friday's all right, 88. And then next Saturday, partly sunny and 88 degrees. So delightful out there today, turning more uncomfortable for tomorrow.
Thank you so much, Chris Sauer. That was Chris Sauer from 6ABC Action News telling us about the weather. Thank you so much for that. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to continue to keep calling in. If you would like to pray, I know a lot of people who are supporters of mine doesn't speak, doesn't flow fluently in English, should I word it. So if you want to call in and pray or intercede in French, in Italian, and Spanish, and Portuguese, and whatever your language is, and Jamaican, whatever it is you want to pray and intercede for someone or something, go ahead and do so. You can call, and you can, we can put you on the air as well. 215-472-0882. That's 215-472-0882. So thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to continue waiting for your call. The current time is 9:50. You're tuned in to WPEB 88.1 FM on Hope for Philadelphia. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Help by Erica Campbell.
Hands up high. EC. LaCroix. West, I need you daily. Can't lie, say the pain don't faze me. My God, who gon' help these babies?
I've been in the fire so long, I can't get burned no more. I thought you was putting out the flame, but it was rain from the storm. Thoughts over my head, making me stressed all day long. They won't let me rest, it's on my chest. I ain't that strong. I need a lifeline right now. 911 won't do, my back's against the wall now. Done all that I could do. I prayed every prayer, went to every service like I know how. Just a ship without a sail. I'm lost without your help. I need help. Oh, Lord, I need your help. 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 Ooh, oh, help. Ooh, Lord. But it ain't about my will, it's all about what you want. Your family used to be first, things getting worse in my home. My brother is hurt, we need a word, it's too far gone. I need a lifeline right now, 911 won't do. My back's against the wall now, done all that I could do. I prayed every prayer, went to every service like I know how. Just a ship without a sail, I'm lost without you.
Out. I can't tell my right from my left now. But my mama's crying cause my daddy's dying. He got pains all in his chest now. My daughter's having these nightmares. I might be wrong, but I'm right here, yeah. I'm trying to hold on when my hands hurt or the ropes out. Cause my life fights, it don't fight fair. So I'm leaning all on these ropes now. And I got hope, but it's low now. So I'm leaning all on these quotes now. Like never leave me, won't forsake me. If you don't help me, I don't make it.
That was Erica Campbell, Help, featuring Lecrae. Ladies and gentlemen, you're tuned in to Hope for Philadelphia on Philadelphia's WPEB 88.1 FM. Everybody who tuned in on Ustream, I'm not sure if the volume is okay. If it's too loud and you're hearing like a popping sound, if you can kindly send us a Facebook message on our facebook.com/hopeforphiladelphia. But if you can hear us nice and clear and it's okay, amen. Amen to that. And thank you for tuning in, by the way. Thank you for tuning in. We do have some viewers on our Ustream. So all morning, we are praying in. We want to definitely pray. And I want you to definitely go ahead and call us. Leave your prayer request or pray. So if you want to pray specifically or if you have a prayer request, go ahead and give us a call, 215-472-0882, to be on the radio. The line is available right now to be off the radio. radio. If you feel shy talking on the radio, but you would still like us to pray for something, you still have a prayer request, go ahead and give us a call at 215-472-0881. If you feel too shy and you don't feel comfortable speaking at all, you can message us on our Facebook page. That's facebook.com/hopeforphiladelphia. And of course, you can always also comment on our prayer page, which is, if you search on Facebook, Hope for Philadelphia prayer page. And we're going to begin reading the comments off of there, or actually the prayers off of there, should I say, very shortly. But before we do that, I'm going to I do have an announcement that Jeremy would like me to present. And so the reason why we were talking about bats earlier, if you tuned in at the very beginning of the broadcast, we were talking about bats and butterflies, right, and things like that, because Jeremy is a good Jeremy. I can say, as a friend, you're a stickler for Green Cycle Alliance. You're a stickler. You're very concerned about the community. You support Green Cycle Alliance, reduce, reuse, recycle a community, yep, very well. Yes. So this is Stop Oil Trains urgent community meeting. Dangerous oil trains in Southwest Philadelphia. Come learn how the 19143 area could be affected by oil train disaster, and talk about what we can do to protect our community and the people across the city. Well, of course, one of the things that you could do is begin praying. Yes. But also, this event, to tell you more about oil train disasters, will be happening on Thursday, July 9th, from 7 to 8:30 p.m. at the King Sessing Recreation Center is located at 4901. So 4901 Kensessing Avenue, not Kensington, Kensessing Avenue. And the logo is Defend Our Community, Our Climate. You can hashtag Stop Oil Trains or go to stopoiltrains.org. And for more information about this event, please email Jeremy Griffin at dygriff95@yahoo.com. Again, it's dygriff, the number 9, the number 5, @yahoo.com. Yes. So if you can just tell me a little bit with the time that we have left before we move on to our next hour, just briefly tell us about what this event will consist of and what it's about.
Right, of course, Cash. So, of course, I'm an environmental activist in Southwest and everything. I'm trying to stop these oil trains. It's a big deal. We got this big energy hub over here. We got a serious issue environmentally in the Southwest community. The 19143 district is actually one of the most threatened zip codes in our area. We have to do something. So Thursday, July 9th, we will be having a community meeting. I will be speaking there. Someone from Delaware River Keepers will be speaking there. Please come. King Sesson Recreation Center, July 9th. We got to figure out this oil trains thing. That's about it, Cash.
Awesome. So oil, if you can give us one fact, tell us why you want to stop oil trains. Tell us why it's important to stop oil trains. Right, what's the difference from keeping them going and actually stopping? Why is this community, the 19143 community, coming up with an event to stop oil trains?
Right. Well, the 19143 area is right in the heart of Southwest Philly. As many of the Philadelphians know, there's a refinery here in South Philly. And oil trains are coming from South Dakota, North Dakota, that kind of area. They're coming on train, bringing a bunch of oil. And as soon as one of these things get derailed off of their track, or even lit on fire, blocks and blocks and blocks would be on fire, actually. So it happened and can happen in my neighborhood, Southwest Philadelphia, King Sesson. So It's an issue. We got to stop it. Come talk about it. King Sesson Recreation Center, July 9th.
Once again, that's Stop Oil Trains Urgent Community Meeting on Thursday, July 9th, 7 to 8:30 p.m. at King Sesson Recreation Center at 4901 King Sesson Avenue. Yep. For more information, go to stopoiltrains.org or email dygriff, the number 9, the number 5, at yahoo.com.
Yes.
Unfortunately, our Ustreamers, I do see that you are that we do have some Ustreamers at the moment. We are still having technical difficulties on the computer. So what we're gonna do is we are going to restart and reboot the computer, which means that for a moment you're gonna be the signal is gonna go off. So I'm gonna give you 10:11. At 10:11, refresh the page. So tune in again to Ustream at 10:11 and do us a favor so you can continue picking us up. So at 10:11, once again, just refresh or re-enter our Ustream page. For now, we're gonna play one more song to fill in this time for our WPEB listeners. Once again, our Ustreamers, we'll see you in just a moment.